Hey, what's up guys, welcome to another video on my YouTube channel, and today I'm going to be showing you how to create a bootable Windows 10 thumb drive using Microsoft Media Creation Tool. Let's go! Somebody roll that intro. So we are back, and the first step you wanna take is head over to your internet browser. Once here, you can do it on any search engine, and you wanna type in Windows 10, press enter, and once you're here, you'll see this first link, which is from Microsoft.com, which is download Windows 10 disk image ISO file. You wanna press on that. And once you're on this website, you get prompted with two options. You can update your current Windows machine, which we're not gonna do today. But what we are going to do is we need the actual tool to create the USB bootable device. So what you wanna do is come down to create Windows 10 installation media. And you're gonna have this download button. You're gonna press that button and you're gonna get prompted with file to be downloaded to your computer. And over here, you wanna press save, and we're gonna wait for that to complete, and it should be done, and it is. What you wanna do now is you can close out of your internet browser and head down to your files, and over here when you're in this window, you wanna head down to this PC and then head over down to downloads. Once you're in downloads, you can see we have Media Creation Tool 1909. What you wanna do is right click on it and run as administrator. You're gonna get prompted and just say yes. As you can see, it's currently loading up and this can take up to a minute. As you can see, the tool has loaded. And the first thing you wanna do is read through the terms of conditions. This is from Microsoft. If you agree to everything that's on here, just press accept. Now we are going to wait for the tool to prepare itself, which depending on your machine also can take a minute to two. And as you can see, it has finished loading. And over here you get prompted with two different options. You can either upgrade the current PC, which we don't wanna do, but what you wanna select is come down here and press on the Create Installation Media USB Flash Drive, DVD, or ISO file for another computer, and press next. When you come over to this page, you'll be prompted to select the language, architecture and edition of Windows 10. What you can do, you can leave this on a recommended settings, but if you wish to download Windows 10 in a different language, what you can do, you can come down to this section, and from this drop down menu you can select all these different languages that you may wish to install on your computer. After you have selected your language, I'm just gonna keep my one on English since I'm in United Kingdom. Windows Edition, we have only one option, and this gives you older Windows Edition like Home, Pro, Enterprise, so we'll just keep it on the standard because there is only one option. And Architecture, if you wish, you can download in both architectures, so you can do 32-bit and 64-bit, or you can do both. Let me show you how you can check what kind of architecture is your computer. You can head to your file as this window. You can go to this PC, right click on it and go down to properties. Once you're in properties and the system type, you'll be prompted to see my architecture on this current system is 64-bit operating system and it's 64 base processor. So we're gonna keep our one on 64. You can close out of this window as well, you don't need it. If your system has 32-bit operating system, you wanna select that, or you can select both if you wish to change your mind later. I'll just keep my one on 64-bit. Press next, and on this page we get prompted with choose which media to use, and you get two options over here, which is a USB flash drive and it needs to be 8 gigabytes or more, or you can create ISO file, which we are not going to do today. So first thing that you wanna do is take your USB thumb drive, and you will need a USB thumb drive of at least 8 gigabytes. What you wanna do is take your USB thumb drive and plug it into your computer. After you have plugged in your USB to your computer, what we're actually gonna do is go to this PC and we're gonna create a blank USB. So any files that you have on this USB, you wanna back them up because we're gonna wipe the drive. If you don't know how to do it, I've made a previous video that you can check out and it will tell you how to do this exact step. So right now what we're gonna do is we're gonna right click on our USB thumb drive and go down to format. Once you're here, what we're gonna do is the volume label, delete that, we don't have to use it, and we're gonna do restore device defaults and we're gonna press start. And it's gonna prompt you that any files on the USB will be deleted and you're gonna press OK. Once the process has completed, you can press OK and your USB has been formatted to the default values. Now you can close out of this window and go back to Windows Media Creation Tool. And over here what you wanna do is select USB flash drive. Once you have done that, you can press Next. And as you can see, it has detected our USB, which is on D drive, no label. And if you go back to your files and this computer, you can see that D drive, which is this one, is exactly the same one that's selected over here. What you wanna do, if you're happy with everything, just press Next. So now the software is getting ready to download Windows 10, and this can depend on your internet speed, and roughly it takes about 20 minutes to complete the whole process. Sometimes it can take a bit more, depending on your internet speed. So right now, feel free to go and grab yourself some coffee and I will see you back when this is complete. So as you can see, it's about 10 minutes later and the download has completed. Now we're gonna wait for the download to transfer to the USB. So as you can see, we have 1% left. And just now your USB was created. So you can press on finish. And that's all, let's have a look. So the first thing you wanna do is go into your files and then go into this PC. And as you can see, we have our Windows 10 bootable USB thumb drive ready. If you go into it, you can see all the Windows files for Windows 10. So from start to finish, it roughly took about 15 to 20 minutes you can expect, depending on your internet speed. So as you can see guys, it's really simple, it's very fast, and it's easy to create your own bootable Windows 10 thumb drive. And it's free, that's what's most important, it's free, you don't have to pay nothing for it. And the next step would be to eject your USB thumb drive and plug it into a blank computer or a laptop so you can install your new Windows 10 on your new machine. So yeah guys, that's pretty much all for today's tutorial. If you enjoyed the tutorial, please make sure to like, subscribe, comment, that will help me a lot, and I will see you in the next one. Peace out.